So I have a budding astronaut at home. Today's Science of It experiment might just be what you're looking for.
Yeah, I visited the Orlando Science Center all month long. They've been dubbing as Space Month. And I got a hands-on lesson this time in making moon sand. And the chances are very likely that you have the ingredients to do this yourself in your home right now. Well, July is Astronomy Month here at the Orlando Science Center. And today we're going to do a fun activity that you can recreate at home. We've got Tori with us here at the Science Center. Thanks again for being here with us this morning. What are we doing with this today?
All right, so today we're going to be making moon sand. So it's kind of a fun sensory mixture. It can be moldable. You can do all kinds of things with it. We're going to theme it to Astronomy Month because here at the end of the month, we are launching the Perseverance rover as well. So we're kind of just staying on theme with space as
awesome.
Much as possible. So this is a really simple recipe. I've already pre-measured out 8 cups of flour in each of the bigger beakers and 1 cup of baby oil. So we're gonna use an 8-to-1 ratio. That is the same thing that can be recreated at home. So if you want, you can actually go ahead and pour this huge container of flour all into your big mixing bin.
Is it one heap?
Yeah, one heap.
Okay, one
we're gonna
heap.
Do it all in one shot.
Okay.
All right, and you can go ahead and add the baby oil all over it, and then you're gonna just start mixing it with your hands. It's gonna get a little messy.
All right.
So the baby oil will start to combine with the flour and turn into what is gonna be our moon sand.
This feels weird.
Yeah, it feels pretty weird. It's definitely a sensory experience.
Yes.
So make sure you get all that baby oil because it'll make it more moldable.
Okay.
All right. And then once you even think it's all mixed in, you can use your hands and kind of do it like this, and it'll make it more fine.
Oh, okay.
It'll break up those chunks.
Interesting. Oh, I still have baby oil over here.
Yeah, there you go. You got to mix it all in. We have fun with this sensory mixture with shells and doing impressions and stuff like that.
Okay.
So it's all kinds of ways you can use it. And it's relatively cheap and easy to find things at home.
How do you know when it's all mixed together?
It's kind of more so your preference.
Okay.
So if you want it to be like super soft, kind of like beachy sand, then you can continue. But for the purposes of our activity, as long as the baby oil is all kind of mixed together, you can go ahead and stop.
Okay.
All right.
You think
you're good?
I think we've recreated some moon sand.
Yeah, so it's nice and soft and clumpy and... So what we're going to do today is do a crater activity because we have craters on the moon, which craters are formed by asteroids that are rocks from space. So we're going to kind of drop different craters into our moon sand surface and see how it happens.
Okay.
All right. So I have 2 rocks for you there on your side. Oh, mine's over here. So you can go ahead and like drop it at different heights. Try different rocks of shapes and sizes and see like the different impressions that they make in your moon sand.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then you can even like build it up really high and see how far down your crater goes into your moon sand.
Yeah, I want to see how this one works.
Try out all different kinds of ways to do it. And
like
if folks
have... Like there was a mountain on the moon.
Yeah. And if folks at home want to make this recipe x4, they can have like a ton of moon sand and really go for it.
So when you're not doing this for Astronomy Month, what sort of things? You said beach shells and other
things? Yeah, we use shells sometimes to do fun impressions. You can also use like cookie cutters.
Okay.
And also we sometimes just even throw in some dinosaurs, just different manipulative like little figurines are fun to play with it too.
Sure.
And it doesn't really dry out. You can keep it for a long time.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's just a fun sensory mixture.
That's great.
Yeah, we encourage to make it more moon space centric. You can drop rocks into it, try different heights. You can even try different objects like different toys that you have, see what kind of impressions they can make. But yeah, that's your moon sand. It's like endless fun. There's all kinds of things you can
endless
do with it.
Endless fun, yes. It's kind of like the beach and you're in space.
Exactly, beach and space together. So we're going to have this as a blog post on our OSC at Home page at osc.org, where we're going to have a video as well as pictures and instructions to be able to recreate the same activity at home, as well as some prompts to kind of keep your fun going.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Right on. That's great. Tori, thanks so much for walking us through how to make moon sand and keep the fun going.
Yeah, and thanks for being here. Again, we're open and we're excited to have everybody back again. We have so many safety measures that we've started to put in place, and it's been going really well, and we just really want to see everybody back in the building.
For sure. Thank you.